Hey guys, it's Meg. So I wanted to create a really educational video on eyeshadow. I wanted to kind of explain just the framework of eyeshadow and the artistry behind it, because makeup is just such an art, and this video is perfect for you if you're a beginner or you've been doing makeup for years and you're a professional. I really hope you take something from this video. I know you will. It's very information packed, so we're just gonna jump right on into it.
Hey guys, and for those of you that want to jump straight to the eyeshadow looks, you guys can skip ahead to 5 minutes. But I'm really quickly going to go over some terminology that I'm going to be using throughout the video and for your knowledge. So first we have the fold crease, which is right above the mobile lid. Then we have the inner lid, and then the outer V, which is just kind of a more sharp, more defined version of the inner lid. And then we have the tear duct in the inner corner, and then we have the brow bone. And then we have the waterline, and then the lash line. Alright, so eyeshadow is taking eyeshadow and using it to mimic or fake or just enhance the natural shadows in the eye socket. And so here in the Mona Lisa by Leonardo da Vinci, we can see a method called chiaroscuro. You may recognize it from Michel Fon's chiaroscuro contour stick. Maybe? Yes? No? Maybe not. Okay, moving on. It's basically a method that gives something that's basically flat more depth. So you would use darker pigment to make something look like it's receding, to make it look like it has shadow, and using lighter paints to bring something forward. So on Mona Lisa, which is obviously flat, she's 2D, she's a painting, he'd use his darker paints and lighter paints to make it seem more three-dimensional and more realistic and more dramatic. Okay, and now that leads me to different eyeshadow types. So you have three. You have mattes, satins, and shimmer and glitter. So matte is basically something with no shimmer, no glitter, does not reflect light whatsoever, it's very flat. And shimmer and glitter, which is the one on the bottom, it's just very reflective, very fun, very sparkly, reflects a lot of light. Then lastly we have satin, which is definitely in between. People get kind of confused about it, but it's somewhat sparkly, somewhat matte. So going back to the whole idea of eye shadow, we're focusing on the shadows of the eyes. So while your eye may already have natural shadows, we're using eyeshadow to really enhance that or fake it. So let's look at the sphere. So let's say this is your eye, just kind of like one solid color, your skin tone. And then eyeshadow is basically adding that dark shadow and also the highlight, which is that little like white center. Basically, as you can tell, your eye is drawn more to the ball on the right rather than the left, and because there's just more contrast, there's more drama. So with eyeshadow, you want to use the darker colors wherever you want to add shadow, wherever you want it to look like it's receding. And with whatever you want to bring forward, you reuse lighter colors like white or beige. And we're not just going to be working with browns and beige or blacks and white, we're going to be working with different versions of a color. So let's say you want to bring something forward, but you want to do like a pink look. So you're adding white to a certain color. So a pure form of color is called a hue, and if you add white to it, it's called a tint. So whatever you want to bring forward that still has some color in it, that's a tint. And if you want to do for the outer V of your pink look, you would use like a burgundy color, that would be a shade because you're adding black to that hue. Or red in this case. This is what I learned in art school, everybody. So going back to shadows, highlighting is just as important as working with shadows and darker colors. So look at the ball on the right. That little tiny amount of white just brings your eye more to it. It enhances it so much more. And comparing this to eyeshadow, it could be that little amount of white or glittery eyeshadow that everyone puts in their tear ducts or their brow bone. So next is blending. You've probably heard this term many times when it comes to makeup, because it is just that important. Not just with the eyes, the whole entire face. So for here, for as an example, I'm a very visual person, so I'm trying to include visual examples. On the left we have a ball that's just black and white, and then on the right we have different levels of gray. It's more of a gradient, nice, it's pretty, and that's kind of what it's like with makeup. So rather than just having like different layers of color, it's just so much more seamless when it all just blends together, and it also appears to be more natural.
Because when you think about natural shadows on the face or on any object, it's very gradual. You don't see any blocks of value. So how to do this with eyeshadow, besides blending a lot with good makeup brushes, is something called transition eyeshadow. So basically you're using a transitional color, usually a few shades darker than your natural skin tone, and they could be warm, cool, or neutral based on your look and your skin tone. And neutral colors, by the way, are colors that are not found on the color wheel, and they're also known as earth tones. Next, I really want to encourage you guys to figure out what type of skin tone that you guys have if you don't already know. You can figure out what kind of skin tone you have by looking at the color of your veins. If it's purple or green, you're neutral. If it's dark blue, you're cool. And if it's light blue, you're warm. This will help you find out what colors look better on your eye. If you find yourself looking better in red and golds, you're probably warm. And if you feel like your face looks brighter when you wear blues and silvers, you're probably cool. But anyway, transitional eyeshadow, it's what you pop in the crease and you blend it out. Not only does it help with blending and make it seem like you have more of a seamless look, but it's just helping with whatever's on your lid blend into more of your skin tone and, I guess you can say, a more natural look. Transitional eyeshadows are usually always matte. You can get away with the satin, but I do recommend matte. And if you're also putting eyeshadows in the bottom lash line, you also want to transition it out with a transitional color. And if you guys don't have any transitional eyeshadow colors, you can just use a bronzer. Those work great.
So I'm about to show you guys the top 6 ways to apply eyeshadow. These are not set in stone. You're not restricted to these. These are more of like a foundation or an inspiration. There's no set rules to do makeup, but these are just kind of like, you know what I'm saying? All right, let's go into it.
Okay, so I made this template on Illustrator. So the first eye that I'm showing you guys is the horizontal gradient method, also known as the smoky eye, where we have colors going from dark to light on the lid. The look is really good if you have really prominent eyelids, but it's also very universally flattering. And for the sake of the video, I'm going to copy whatever that's on the top lid on the bottom lash line. So obviously, as you guys can tell, the dark green represents the darkest color, which you would pack on the lid. And I hope you guys can pick it up, but you guys can see the transitional color, which is kind of that tan color in the crease. So the key to having a smoky eye is making sure that you're really blending out everything. And the thing with eyeshadow, let's say you're working with a red and a yellow. You can't really just mix them hoping you have an orange as a gradient in between. You need to add an orange. So here, if you want to fade out, you need to add a lighter green. So next we have the vertical gradient method, also known as the fan shape. So that's where you're going from light to dark, from the inner corner to the outer corner. And so you're basically just packing on yellow in the inner corner, green in the middle, like the highest point of your eye, and then the green in the outer V. This one is probably the most common eyeshadow look, and it just really just brings a lot of dimension to the eye, and it just also brings so much attention to it with the lighter color in the middle. For a hooded eye, you just kind of want to bring it above more of your natural crease. If you guys want to see a video on eyeshadow more for hooded eyelids, because I have hooded eyelids, I'd be more than happy to do that for you. Just let me know in the comments below. So next we have Snow Globe. Snow Globe is one of my favorites. It's just really rounds out the eye. So if you have flat eyes, I really recommend this look for you. So you're going to put the darkest color in the inner corner and the outer corner. So it really just brings this very center of your eyelid pop out. And you're just going to blend the yellow and the dark green together. Depending on how dark of an eyeshadow you use, it can be very dramatic. But I like to do it underneath like a layer of glitter on the lid. So it just gives that dimensionality back in my eye that one layer of glitter of any color just kind of takes out. Alright, so next I wanted to take the past 2 eyeshadow looks and bring them together and ask you guys what you think is different between the two. And take note that the template that they're on is the exact same. So as you can see, the one on the left is a lot more rounded and the one on the right is a lot more elongated and it's more almond shaped. And I've noticed that people with round eyes want it to have more of that almond shaped and people with almond shaped eyes want it to be more rounded. So you can do either with any eyeshadow look. So if you wanted a more rounded out eye shape, so you would just kind of focus more in the actual crease of your eyeball. So you would feel where your eyeball rounds out under the skin. And if you wanted a more almond shaped, you kind of go beyond the crease and kind of towards the end of the eyebrow and you're going past the eye. All right, so next we have cut crease. I love me some cut crease. So it's a one solid color that's on the lid of the eye. It's usually a very light shade. And then the crease, it's very blended up from the crease to the brow bone, but from the lid to the crease, it's not blended at all. There's a very harsh line making the lid pop and the crease also pop and really just seem like it's receding in. I love this look. It looks gorgeous on everybody. It's great. It's a little bit trickier to master, but practice does make perfect. So next one is the outer V, or also known as the closed banana. So you're really emphasizing the outer portion of your eye. You're really kind of carving it and making it really enunciated. And it's kind of like wing liner, but you're going into the crease. This doesn't have to be blended, or it could be. It could be like a cut crease where it's strictly contrasted between the light shadow and the dark shadow, or you can blend them together. For me, I see this as like a kind of like a winged liner, but going into the crease, and it looks really good with a sharp wing. So next we have cat eye. So it's very geometric shape and there's not a lot of blending. You're following the shape of your lid, but then at the very tip, you just kind of go straight towards the very edge of your brow. You can really do anything with this one as far as you're just like following the outline of the cat eye. You can fill it in with like the gradient fan shape. You can make it all one solid color. You can smoke it out. You can do whatever you want with it.
So although I just taught you guys the main 6 ways of doing eyeshadow, those aren't set in stone. Those are just kind of the foundation or inspiration for you. You can do no transition color, you can mix them, you can do whatever you want. There's no right or wrong way to do it. Makeup is a form of self-expression and you should do what you want to do, not because it should be done in a certain way. And I'm also going to challenge you guys not to get stuck on one. For me, for years, I was stuck on the fan shape one, you know, the gradual vertical one. And if you're watching this video and you've been doing one, I'm inviting you to leave your comfort zone. You know, I got a snow globe going on today. Proud of myself. My advice to you is go practice. Go practice. Go practice on yourself. Go practice on your neighbor, your friend, anyone you want, your dog. Okay, don't your dog. That'd be a little weird. I like to practice a lot before I go to bed. I don't want to scare anyone with my smoky eye. But no, the world should embrace our smoky eyes. You know what I mean? They're not ready for us. And most importantly, I want you guys to know you are beautiful with and without makeup. You are gorgeous if you have a hot cut crease, and you're stunning without any eyeshadow on. So I love you guys. Have a great day. I'm thinking about making a part two for this video, explaining more about actually how to apply eyeshadow, eyeshadow brush types, different types of eyeshadow in itself, like powder, liquid, or whatever types of questions come up after this video. So let me know if you guys want to see a part two. Subscribe to my channel for more videos like this, and I hope I see you again. I love you.